Hey guys, welcome back. It's me, Ranjan Sharma, and this is part 4 of API integration and with MySQL PHP Wally. So, you know guys, in this tutorial we are going to learn that how can we update data in MySQL database using API from our Android app. So first of all, what we have to do is we have to open this API tutorial folder, and here you can see that we already have three PHP files: delete, get, insert. So I have shown you three operations using API. Now this tutorial is about fourth operation, and that is update. So simply create a rich text document and just give it a name. We just have to edit it, I mean rename it, and give it name update, and just make it php update php, then again yes, and now we have the file. So after that you have to click on this write and sublime text. So now we have the file. So after that guys, we will code inside it that how can we make it possible to update data in MySQL using PHP. So first thing that we will do here is you just have to copy this first part of the code. So simply copy it from here and then open this update PHP, then paste it, and here you have to close that PHP file. Yeah, so now I have closed that. So after that, here what exactly I will do is that I will create four variables, and I will create, so for that you can just come here and simply copy this code from insert.php and paste it here, because we have to do the same thing, and you just have to copy this one and paste it at the first number, and just make it ID, because we need one more parameter, and here make it ID. That's okay. So now we have ID, name, age, gender, understand? So after that we will write a SQL query. So first of all, SQL equals to double quotation, and inside it update keyword we will use it, and the table name is users, so update users, and then after that again set, and then name equals to single quotation, and inside that write dollar name, name, and then again comma, and after that age, so equals to single quotation, then dollar age, then comma, then again third parameter will be gender, so simply write gender equals to single quotation and dollar gender. Now after that, just after that gender, you have to write where, and now we will use that ID for updating data, so single quotation and again dollar ID, and then after that semicolon. So first of all, what we will do is that we will update users, understand? So we set will set the data, and here we are comparing that when if it have a name value, so you have to give name value, and if the child, I mean the value of the column is age, so it will update age, and if it is gender, so it will update gender, and then the validation works here where ID equals to ID. It means that it will check that if the ID is 3, so it will update the column number 3, I mean row number 3, if the ID is 4, so it will update the row number 4. So that's pretty simple, and after that we will declare a variable for checking that is it done or not. So for this we will simply use mysql like underscore query query, then brackets, and here we will simply write that con connection, and second parameter will be sql, done, then semicolon. So after that what here you have to do is if and else for checking that is it done or not. So simply write if, and here write dollar, that will be result. So if it is true, so we will simply echo that, and the message will be data updated, and in the ending semicolon, and in the else part if there is some error, so we will handle it also. So here you just have to echo that failed, that's okay, and after that here in the ending we will close this connection simply. So yeah, here write my sqli underscore connection, I mean close my sqli mysqli underscore close, then bracket and pass con, and simply write semicolon, and now I hope our coding part is almost correct and there is no error. So now you can see the codes that let me reduce the size. Yeah, now it's the everything is visible. So guys, now you can see that our API PHP part is almost done. So you just have to create a connection, then four variables, understand? Then we will run a SQL query, and then we have a variable for result, and after that we are checking is it done or not, and in the ending we are closing the connection. That's all, understand? And after that simply control plus s and save the file. Now it's time to open the Android Studio and do the further work. So first of all guys, here you can see that this is our API application. So here first of all you just have to click on this new and create activity. So go for activity and empty activity and give it a name, and give it name edit activity, edit activity, and VT, enter. Just wait for the Gradle part, just for few seconds. So guys, now the activity is created successfully. So again, come back in this show data, and now here we will handle the case that what we have to do when you will click on the edit data button. So first of all here, before that I would like to get the strings. So first of all I will write data class ArrayList dot get pass index I, then dot get age, and it will just make things easy. So just do whatever I'm doing, and gender equals to data class ArrayList dot get, and that will be I dot get gender, then semicolon, and then after that simply control plus C and control plus V. So after that just make it name and make this one ID, and just here you have to retrieve name, and here you have to retrieve get ID. Done. So now we have all the parameters that we need. So after that here case number 0 is for editing. So we will simply use the intent. So write intent equals to new intent, and after that here you have to pass show data because this is our parent, then dot this, and then after that activity where we want to go, edit activity dot class, and then semicolon, then simply write intent dot put extra, and first parameter will be name. So simply give name, and the value will be name semicolon, and second will be name dot put extra, and it is age. So simply write age, give name A, and third one is for gender. So again intent dot put extra and write G, and the value will be gender, then semicolon, and then again intent dot put extra, and just simply fourth parameter is ID. So simply write ID and comma pass value ID, now semicolon, then after that in the ending start activity and pass intent. So now intent is done. Understand? So when the user will click on the button edit data, so we will simply go to the activity edit activity, and now we have to handle this edit activity. So first of all I will simply go to this split section, and I will zoom it a little bit, and then after that simply change this constant layout to linear layout, and after that you have to make it orientation, and that will be vertical obviously, and just add some padding or not required. So after that we will use some edit text. So simply write edit text, that will be 300 dp is fine, and then height rep content, then hint, that will be id, and then id, that will be id et, then text color, that will be android black is okay, and then close it, and here you just have to give gravity, and not layout gravity, only gravity, and that will be center. So now it is in the center, understand? So now we have the ID. So after that you just have to do is simply copy it, and control plus v, and we have four edit text. Yeah, that's okay. So now let me make it easy to understand, and now we have the, so here you just have to do a simply write enabled and make it false, because only for ID, understand? Not for everyone. So after that ID we will update the name. So make this hint name, and change the ID, so make it name et, understand? And then after that it will be for age, so it will be for age, and then after that this one will be for gender, and this one will be for gender. So now we have the gender et, understand? So I guess almost everything is correct. So now we have four edit text, ID, name, age, gender. So after that we will use a button for updating, so that will be also rep content, and text is going to be simply update, understand? And then give ID that btn underscore update, okay, close it, and just give some margin in the top like 10 dp, that will be okay, and then after that in the last we will simply use a progress bar in order to show some, you know, good user experience. So make it rep content, and visibility will be invisible, and now it's not visible in the screen, so just give some margin top, and that will be 20 dp, And then ID will be progress bar, so PB, then close it. That's okay. And here we have the close progress bar. So after that, you have to come in this Java part, understand? And first of all, I will declare variables. So yeah, and after that, you just have to write string that will be name, age, gender, because we will retrieve those data from previous activity. So that's why we need the strings. And the last thing is string URL, and that will be for update URL. Now leave it for now and we will handle it in few seconds. So after that, I will give reference for all of them. So is now I have given the reference for all the childs. So after that, I will simply use bundle. So write bundle equals to, and then after that, bundle equals to get intent, then dot get extras semicolon, and then after that I will simply write if bundle not equals to null. So simply write not equals to null and starting ending bracket and else part. So show a toast message not received, and now we will handle this if part. So inside it, what we have to do is we will simply use the name string that we declared above. So simply write bundle then dot get string, and now we need the name. So simply give name and then just semicolon. So bundle dot get string n, so it will get the value of n, control plus v, control plus v, and again control plus v. Yeah, so after that name, make it id, and then make this one age, and make this one gender, not et, only gender. And so make this one g, and make this one a, and make this one I. So name n, id I, age a, gender g. Make sure this value should be same, name n, age a, gender g, id I, understand? So that's okay for now. So after that, simply do is write age et dot set text, and that will be age. Then name et dot set text, that will be name, and then id et dot set text, and that will be id, and then after that last one gender et dot set text, that will be gender. So now we have done everything. So now it's time to handle the button. So yeah, simply write button dot set on click listener, then new, then on click listener, understand? And then after that, you just have to also again open this main activity and copy this code from here, control plus c, and go back in edit activity. And if you don't know that how I'm copying all the code, so watch the first, second and third part, then come on this fourth one. So after that, here you just have to make changes in this small changes like this, and then also make it edit activity, not text. So after that, just make it edit activity and just remove this part. And here you just have to do is after that, let me make a change. So also increase a parameter, control plus C. So just simply make control plus V and make it ID. And here you have to write is ID. Yeah. Simply write id et dot get text dot to string. Okay, so now what we will do here is we have to show the response, and I will also make the progress bar set visibility invisible, but when the user will click, so we will make it progress bar dot set visibility visible, understand? So just after that, we will get the strings like name, and it should be name for updating. So simply write name et dot get text dot to string semicolon, name up, and then after that simply control plus d, and then again control plus d. So name up, and then after that age up for updating, and the last one is of course gender up. So here just make it age et and make this one gender et, and now we have the updated codes for that. So what we can do here is just simply make it name for update and age up and gender up. So now we have done almost everything. Yeah, I guess. So on a response. So guys, in case if we response any face any errors, also make it set visibility invisible. Yeah, that's okay. So now we have the parameters. So we have done almost everything. So guys, now it's time to open MySQL and click on this tools file manager first of all, and go on this upload files and click on this public HTML and upload files. I'll go back in the folder and this API tutorial folder, and make sure you have saved this update.php file, control plus S, and then go back and drag it. Drag it Chrome. Upload 100% uploaded. So now here we have the update file. So simply click on this, copy it, cancel it, click on it, then go for view and wait until it is loading. Now simply copy this URL from here, control plus C, close this tab, go back in Android Studio and the place where we left for URL. So paste it here. Now we have the update PHP file. Understand? And check the reference and check almost everything. Check reference, check ID, check edit text, check this Revoli string request. And after doing all that, so now it's time to run the application. So guys, you can see that the application is running absolutely okay, and we have three data in our MySQL database. So I would like to update to my name Rajan. So I will click on the first number and edit data. So here you can see that it is showing my ID, my name, my age, and my gender. So now I will make see, we cannot update the ID. So if I'm clicking on the number one edit text, so it is not making any changes. And if I will click on this Rajan, so you can see that it is now I will change the name and I will click on the button update. The progress bar working fine, data updated, and why is it a big toast message? So data updated, and so this time when I will refresh, so my name should be Rajan Sharma. Loading, 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 and Rajan Sharma. It is working absolutely okay. So now I will update the age 22 and male star, or don't change it, update. So let's see it is updating age or not. So data updated, then refresh. So guys, you can see that my age is 22. So the application is working absolutely okay. Data is updating very successfully. So guys, if you like this video, so please like, share, and subscribe my channel, and also join the membership for the source code, because I will upload the source code as soon as I can. So guys, if you like this video, so please like, share, and subscribe my channel, and do not forget to press the bell icon so you will never miss any update. Thank you for watching.